Hi, my name is Bhop Singh and I'm a product specialist here at Haas. Today we'll be looking at using probing on our turning centres. Now probing on a lathe should be as easy as probing on a mill, right? Unfortunately, even with probe manual in hand, it seems there are knowledge barriers that keep it from being simple and straightforward. This is why most lathe probes can be found in cabinets, drawers or still in the box. In this video, we'll focus on how the probing templates in our visual programming system make probing much easier than it was in the past, and hopefully convince you to keep it in your turret and not in the box. So before we go through the whole process in detail, let's jump over to watch the probe in action. We'll look at one of the most common inspection procedures on a lathe, measuring a bore. Just to show you how easy it is to go from VPS template to actually running the probe routine. We are jumping ahead. We've already indicated the probe on centerline. It's touched off on the Z face of this machine part, and it's already gone through the probe calibration routine. We'll look at all this again in a minute. I'll press edit and cursor up to the VPS tab and then move down to the probing tab and then arrow right. We are going down to measure and right arrow to enter this menu. We have several routines we can select and we're going to cursor down to the X diameter measure file. On the screen, you can see the animation is showing the probe touching both sides of the part on the OD and the ID of the X axis. Let's select this. I'll enter the tool number where the probe is mounted, the probe offset, and enter work offset numbers. Next up is wear compensation. If you have an automated setup, you will probably want this turned on, so wear offset changes can happen automatically. Now we will enter the offset we want compensated. My finish ID boring bar is in station number 3, so I'll enter that here. Next line is asking you to choose which feature needs probing. Is it ID or OD? We are measuring this bore, so I'll enter ID. Next, I'll choose 2-touch, since the blueprint calls out plus or minus 1 thou tolerance, and I want the best accuracy. Then, my nominal diameter is 1.176, so I'll enter that here. I'll leave the Z approach at 1/2 inch, and the next line is basically asking you how deep in the bore do you want the probe to perform the check. You will notice it is not a negative value. I'll set my measure distance at 350 thou. I'll finally enter my diameter tolerance. My drawing says plus or minus 1, so I'll enter that here. Now, I press F4 and 2 to send the program to MDI, and I'm ready to measure. So, that was it. It didn't take long, did it? Just over 2 minutes to enter the data and run the program. Super easy and no programming. Let's see if the probe performed correctly. There are notes at the top of the sequence that display which macro variable location show the measured size and what the error was. Let's go check those for a moment. Here are the values in variables 10174 and 10175. For added convenience, I've used a neat feature to show these values on the timers tab on the main page without having to navigate through the macro variables. There's a tip of the day that shows you how to do this easily. Now we see the probe measure the bore at 1.175 and 7 temps, and it's 3 temps from the nominal. And let me just check this dimension with a bore gauge. Yep, 3 temps under my nominal. I purposely loaded this part that is slightly undersized to illustrate what you typically see after you've been running the boring cycle for a while and your insert was wearing. Also, if we check the tool wear page, we can see that the probe has adjusted the boring bar, tool number 3, by the same amount in the correct direction to machine the next part closer to the nominal. Still not sure if you need a probe on your lathe yet? There are two likely scenarios where you'd want a probe system taking measurements similar to this one. First off, if you're setting up an automated process on your machine, like on one of our APLs, or maybe a robot, you really want to be sure of two things: that your parts are being loaded correctly and they are being machined to blueprint specs. No one wants to get to work in the morning only to find a table full of machined parts that are all out of spec. This is probably where a probe is of utmost importance. But you might also want to probe features on your part for size, even on a hand-loaded machine or when you're using a bar feeder. where you need to make frequent wear offset changes, or you have one operator manning several machines and you want the probe to cover some of the workload. Now you've seen one of the most common inspection procedures, let's go back and go into detail with the other routines and probe setup. We've broken these templates into two groups, one dedicated to calibrating the probe and one dedicated to measurement routines. We could have just shown you the measurement routines and made this video shorter, but we've chosen to show both calibration and measurement stages since you will be using both of these back and forth as you set up new jobs and existing jobs. Okay, let's get into it. I'll press edit and cursor up to the VPS tab and then move down to the probing tab. Then arrow right. You'll see the tool offset at the top. This is for setting your turning tool and live tool offsets using the ATP arm. But we're going to arrow down to calibration and right arrow to enter this menu. We'll talk about the difference between calibration and measurement in a minute. But to begin, let's go through the first four steps we have on the page here. We've already trammed and indicated the probe, and we've set our probe Z geometry offset using the ATP arm. These two steps are done when first installing the probe, and then not again unless the probe tool holder is moved or bumped. Now for step three, you can choose to make a dedicated gauge ring, but I'm going to show you how to use the part you're already making as your gauge ring. Step four, we've already completed. Here, we just touched off the face of our part to establish an accurate Z position relative to our part. All right, that took us a minute, but now we've reached step five, X calibration to master gauge ring. This is a calibration routine we'll be using most regularly and the one we used to set up the sequence at the beginning. Now is a good time to stop and talk about the difference between calibration and measure. We'll see in a minute that these two cycles are very similar. We start with calibration because this is where we let the control know the difference between where the machine is moving and where the probe is triggering. This calibration step is how we marry those together to get accurate measurements from the probe. Basically, in calibration mode, you are telling the probe the dimension it is probing, and in measure mode, the probe is telling you the dimension it just probed. Okay, enough talk about why we need to calibrate our probe. Luckily, it's easy to get done. We're on step five and I'll arrow to the right. I'll enter the tool number and offset number for my probe. Tool 9 in this case. Then the work offset I'm using for my part. Here, since we already calibrated the ID, let's now calibrate this outside diameter, which I just measured at 1.2883 with a micrometer. And remember, when you're doing both OD and ID measuring, you need to calibrate both, since probe triggering can be slightly different in either direction. Calibration adjusts for these differences. Next, we'll select two touch. This will always give you a more accurate reading and is almost always preferred during calibration. And of course, two touch calibration is equally valid for one or two touch measuring cycles later on. Next, we'll choose where we want to measure. This diameter here on my part has a tolerance of plus or minus 1 thou and a nice smooth finish, so it will work fine for our reference diameter. The default half inch Z rapid approach is fine. Last, I'll set my Z measure distance to 350 thou. This is from the Z0 front face of the part to the tip of the stylus, so you know this will clear the 400 thou deep shoulder. Now I'll press F4 and then 2 to output the code to MDI. Everything looks good, so I'll hit cycle start. The probe will come in and touch off each side of the part. All moves forward towards the part and during measuring are all protected moves. This means the control is monitoring the probe output, looking for unplanned collisions. So if you enter something incorrectly or the probe hits an unexpected obstruction, it will stop before damaging the probe. Once the measurement cycle is complete, the probe will retrace its steps at full rapid since it knows the path is already clear. Okay, so X diameter calibration is complete. Now, of course, once calibrated, the probe can check any number of different diameters with the same degree of accuracy. And once you're in production measuring parts, running this calibration step when you need it shouldn't take more than a minute since typically all the values we just entered will remain the same. Moving to step 6, doing a Y-axis calibration follows exactly the same steps as we just completed for X, and it is necessary when you're ready to start measuring using the Y-axis motion. Step 7 also works similar to other templates. Input the various values that reflect your part geometry and the machine does the rest. Okay, it's time to actually measure our part. From probing, we'll select measure. Here, we can set a new work offset, check X runout, check X and Y diameter, and check Z depths, grooves, and ribs. Next on the list is X check runout. This is a great one for monitoring an automated process, and we'll come back to it after we've looked at X diameter measure. So, we ran the sequence to probe the ID at the beginning for the demo, and another cool thing is when we go back to this template, we can see that the data we entered earlier is still in the value column. Pressing origin can reset the table to original default values, but we will leave them and just overwrite each value. We are going to keep the same tool, offset and work offset numbers as before, and we'll still want to compensate for the wear, but this time instead of the offset compensating on the ID tool, we want it to compensate on the OD tool, which is tool number 5. We can now change the ID to OD. I know we calibrated to the 1.290 diameter, but to show you how versatile the probe is, let's check a different diameter. Again, we want to select 2-touch because it's much more accurate. Our probe tip extension allows us to reach below the bottom of the diameter and perform a 2-touch sequence. This extension and other accessories are provided when you purchase the WIPS L unit. Then enter the diameter we want to measure. Our blueprint calls out 2.5. Same rapid approach. Now, if you look at our blueprint, you can see the probe will reach the 2.5 diameter at this distance. So we'll enter 0.625 here. Finally, change the tolerance from 1 thou to 5 thou. And again, press F4 and 2. Let's run this and see what we get. And we can see the size is 2.4977 and the offset change is 2 thou 3 temps. Let's go to the wear page of the finished turn tool and we can see that the offset has already been adjusted to correct the next part. Let's move down to Y diameter measure. This operates exactly the same as with X diameter. Y-axis machines can reach up to 3.3 diameter with the probe provided. So if you don't want to use the extension and you don't have the adequate reach in X, then this template might be useful. Probably the most common use for Y diameter measure is when you need to check diameter on a longer shaft and you don't have access to the center line because of tailstock support. We have created that template, but it won't be available until the next release. The last two routines provide linear measurements. Z depth measures between two faces along the Z axis. And the groove rib template allows these types of features to be measured after fitting a 90 degree radial stylus to the probe. These are both useful routines, but we'll leave them for now so we can come back to X check runout before we wind things up. Checking your part's runout after it's loaded in the spindle is another important step in many automated turning setups. As the name implies, this program rotates the chuck 3 times in 120 degree intervals and measures the part at each of these positions to yield a runout value that is compared to the tolerance value you've entered. You will notice I've used another of the WIPS L accessories to set the probe in the radial position. There are the usual entries for the tool number, approach, and measure distances. Let's probe this diameter and set the Z distance. You can set the probe to retract after each touch off if there are features that will strike the probe during rotation. And you can specify a particular starting angle if needed. And then of course, the actual maximum allowable runout value. Checking runout on an OP2 part is critical in automation, especially on concentricity callouts from OP1 to OP2. Manually, you would use an indicator to check the runout on the machine surface. Here, we have duplicated that indicator check with the probe option to retract after each touch-off if there are features that will strike the probe during rotation. No alarm, so the machine will continue to run in automation. Let's adjust the part in the machine so it runs out and rerun the sequence. It alarmed out, preventing this part and the following parts from being run out of spec and alerting the operator to loading issues that need to be addressed. This is critical in automation. Using a combination of these various measuring routines will allow you to ensure your part is properly loaded in the chuck before you start machining and that the parts are staying in tolerance when they are being turned. This is almost a necessity if you are running an automatic turning cell, and it can easily save time on manually loaded setups, so your operator can tend to other machines and take care of other tasks. If your turning cell fits either of these cases, we think you should take a look at adding WIPS cell to your lathe. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.